Evening, sports fans. This is Dennis Schroeder with Channel 4 Sports. And what a sporting year this was. Last week, our hockey rink closed, ending a fantastic season of hockey in Eastern Manitoba. A year and a half ago, some open-minded citizens from Pinawa, with a thought to the future, put their heads together to raise money for artificial ice. What these citizens may not have visualized was 209 hockey games, a figure skating display, skill jamborees, two hockey tournaments, and a curling bond field would be played on this same ice surface in 5 months' time. A total of 73 different teams played against our 14 minor teams, our senior Panthers, the old timers, and plant league teams this year. Our arena was visited from hockey teams coming as far away as Dryden, Keewatin, St. Melo, Elm Creek, and Miami. In the arena, we witnessed the Bantam and Tom Thumb Hockey Tournament, a provincial playoff final, and the Northeastern Intermediate Hockey League Championship game. Pinawa team, who had started practices early, played 331 games this year and traveled 23,300 miles in 5 months. The Pinawa Panthers, last year's Northeastern Manitoba Hockey League champion, didn't fare so well this year. Coach Bill Hutchings' team finished a disappointing third after starting off the season well. To sum up the season, after one particular loss, an 8-0 defeat at the hands of the Pine Falls Paper Kings, Coach Hutchings came off the ice and bumped into a lady fan accidentally. Being very polite, he took off his hat and said, "No offense, ma'am." The lady looked right back at him and said, "Darn side little defense, too." But, as we have it, many Pinawa teams did do well. The Midgets, for instance, under Coach Len Horn, won the Midgets Hockey League Championship for this area. The Bantams, who staged a fantastic tournament, played 45 games, the tops in Pinawa, traveling 2,400 miles, including a trip to the United States, and as a finale, won a highly noted Winnipeg tournament. As a further trip is planned on the last Saturday and Sunday in April, it is hoped that many fans will go with the Bantams to Crookston, Minnesota, to support the team. The Pee Wee Lions, under Les Brunel, and the Tom Thumbs, Bison, under Coach Lawrence Farrell, also did well, finishing first in their respective divisions. But, as fate would have it, they lost out in the playoffs. On our monitor, we see the Midgets currently playing Keewatin, Ontario, in an exhibition game. The score ended up 6-4 for the Midgets, but it was a very good game at that. This particular game, outstanding star Jerry Creole, now going around the net, put on a great display of hockey. Here we see Brent Donnelly going up the ice, and later we'll see him pot home a goal. As a finale, hockey season will officially end May 6th, as the Pinawa Minor Hockey presents their hockey banquet at the community center. And we're sorry, mothers, fathers and sons are permitted to go only, and tickets can be obtained from the various coaches involved. The tip of the hat must go out, though, to the many ladies and to the men who offered their many hours of service behind the snack bar counter. In particular, I would like to mention Mrs. Popple, who took much criticism about the coffee. One particular evening, when things weren't going too well and my team was losing, at the end of the second period, I got some coffee. This particular coffee, as it has been throughout the year, wasn't tasting so well. So I went to Mrs. Popple and said, "When are you going to give us some coffee worth drinking?" She must have had a hard day, but she came back with a real snappy remark: "As soon as you can give us some hockey worth seeing." To wind up our hockey, I'd like to mention a little joke. And that's, why do the Montreal Canadiens play hockey in a tree? Don't know? Well, they played against the Maple Leafs, of course. Our arena was visited from many hockey, our arena had some very strange visitors this year. These visitors wore helmets, padded pants, and lots of footballs instead of hockey pucks. These guests, and our strange visitors, of course, used the arena dressing rooms as football came to Pinawa for the first time. 60 boys from Pinawa and Estevan, Saskatchewan, got together on a historic October afternoon to play Pee Wee football. Although the experienced Estevan All-Star team was won handily, the Pinawa team gained much from the exposure to football. After it was all over, plans for the future were formulated. If the Recreation Department cooperates, it is hoped that a massive minor football program can begin. Teams playing six-man football are planned, and age groups from 10, 11, 12, and 13-year-olds are also planned, with approximately three teams in each. The largest obstacle so far is sweaters. We need approximately four more sets of 18 in each set, and about 20 more helmets are needed. But it is hoped that these can be donated or scratched up somewhere from the community. We are also hoping to get a hold of Lac Da Bonnie to get them interested in minor football. Winnipeg has agreed to play exhibition games with Pinawa and has included us in their Winnipeg City Playoffs. A special note goes out to any young football player that would like some special training. This year, there's a special football camp at the Peace Garden, August 6th to 12th. Let's hope that some of our young football players here in the community, ages 12 to 18, will become interested and then go down. Anyone wishing further information can contact me, as I will be one of the instructors there. We have here on our monitor now one of the many activities that went on in this arena. This is where the scouts took part in their jamboree. And this particular thing was the chuck wagon race, the highlight of the jamboree. The Cousin Scouts have approximately 120 members here in Pinawa, with Barry Burnett heading the congregation. Irv Grafsky happens to be the district commissioner. Cousin Scouts happen to do very well in this jamboree, and it's an annual affair that's worth seeing if you haven't seen it. This particular event, the Chuck Wagon Race, is run the same way as the Calgary Stampede, except that we have the boys pulling the chuck wagon. Chuck wagons, of course, aren't hurting the icing. Now we see them off, and you can see it's quite slippery, and they're on skates. Of course, safety is practiced a lot in this type of event. The idea is to get around the rink after going through a couple of obstacles and see who the first one in is. You can see it's kind of a lot of fun. It's a lot of spills and thrills. Besides chuck wagon races, they also have many other type of events in this jamboree. And if you haven't seen it this year, make sure you go next year to see it. The Cousin Scouts have done an outstanding job in our community. As a final windup for sports, what can we look for in the future? Well, this year we can look for baseball on the minor level. Minor sports will also go into football this year, and hopefully we can get enough coaches and referees interested in going through it a big way, providing the recreation department will cooperate. What has the artificial ice done for us? Well, besides playing more games and having more ice time, hopefully someday we can have somebody like a Bobby Orr or a Bobby Hull come out of our ranks to represent Pinawa in the NHL. That is the sports for today.
Point of view, and it might well become one of the most important reasons for having community television. The whole thing about having television in your own community is that you have access to it to express your view on any subject. Point of view tonight comes from Mrs. Edna Graham.